saying time and again that the concept of this art of shorthand, the basic idea behind learning this art of shorthand is to write the words quickly. We found that writing of words with the spelling is difficult. So we have concentrated upon the sound of the word, how it is produced. When the sounds of words are examined, we found that the word sound consists of only two elements, consonants and vowels. Isn't it? Only a word consists of consonants and vowels. Vowels and consonants, consonants also like that. So if we are able to record the consonants and vowels of the word, it means that we have written the word. We observe that there are 24 consonant sounds in the English language and 12 vowel sounds. For all these things we have given signs and symbols. And we have given for each consonant, what are the consonants using P, B, T, D, J, J, K, K, like that. There are 24 consonant sounds, we have provided 24 basic forms. P, B, P, B, K, J, K, K, like that we have given symbols to each consonant. Our idea is to write the words quickly, therefore we have created for a light sound, light stroke, heavy sound, thick stroke, like that. We have been developing the methods of quick reading still. How to abridge the outline of the word. So our intention is to reduce still. We want to reduce the writing time of the consonants. But what we have done are two forms, another alternative form is provided so that we can join the strokes quickly, whichever is convenient. We can use it. So for thick writing, we have started creating abbreviated forms. For a basic form, another basic form is created. Head downward, upward. Another basic form is created, same size, like that. But afterwards, what we have done? We have started creating smaller forms, abbreviated forms. For example, they. A right subject is provided. Then, for S or Z, we have created a small circle. So like this, we are creating new methods, abbreviated forms to write the consonant quickly. Now for single consonant, single form is provided. Now, we want to create smaller forms, abbreviated forms, to represent two consonants at a time, three consonants at a time, whole syllable. Like this we want to create new forms. So we will be going on inventing methods to write the sounds of the English words quickly. Here today, we are going to create a new form which represents two consonants at a time. That means two in one. For example, you see. Yes. J. Two consonants. So two consonants, these are two consonants. Two consonants in one form. That is what we want to create today. Now what is remaining? What is remaining? What is remaining? A circle. So, yes, this is a circle. We know already about small circle representing S or Z. Now, this is large. This is larger than this. This is larger than this small circle. So, let us utilize this device to represent two constants. What were the constants? Earlier you found here? F and A, isn't it?
Yes.
In some words, this and U are put together, mm-hmm. are combined and spoken. Therefore, because this circle, large circle, is a large circle, large. Large circle. Represent a this and a river. Combine. Combine and say that's all. This plus river. Swa. Swa. Okay. So let us see this sound in many words. Sweet. See? How do you write heat? Heat. So this double consonant, this in the swa is represented by a large circle. Large circle. So, swa. That's all. Now, swa plus e. E. Then, t. Sweet. Like this. Yes. Large circle represents swa initially in a word. Sweet, sweet, sweet. Swim. Swim, swim. The rules for writing this large circle are the same as you follow the rules for small circle. Same rules are followed even for large circle as you follow the rules for small circle. Switch, switch, swap, switch. Here, this is swap. Like this you write. Same, just like you write the small circle, you put the large circle. But the point is, initially, that is important. Initial sound of swa in a word is represented by, initial sound of swa in a word is represented by a large circle. Okay, then how do you write swim? Here, initially, in a word. Suppose this is represented by this circle. Where do you put this A? Vowel only. The remaining sound is only vowel. So vowel sound is represented by sway and dot. Where do you put this heavy dot? Because a circle will not have? Will not have? Vowel places. 1, 2, 3. So you will have to necessarily write the other method, the other way. Suppose when you are going to a place, if you miss the train, you will go by bus. Alternative method. Here also we got alternative forms. Now, initial sound of yes, can be represented by a small circle. Now, sway, sway, circle, small circle, way, sway. You can write like this. So, these are very simple rules, very easy. Initial sound of a swa is represented by large circle. Or you can say a large circle represents swa initially in a word. thoughts are medially and finally. Yes, I will come to that point also. Once we thought of writing a large circle, let us use it extensively. The large circle represents Seth or Seth. That means Seth, 2 S's. Okay. Or Seth. Or Zeth. Or Zeth. Like this. Any kind of sound. With an intervening vowel of A. So, read it. Seth. Seth. Zeth. Zeth. We will see the examples also. So, these sounds are written quickly by writing large circle. So, the large circle represents SS with an intervening vowel of A, 2 S's, light or heavy, that means heavy means is, light means is, the combination of S and Z with an intervening vowel of A. Vowel sign. You need not write the vowel sign, not necessary. Now this is a 3-in-1. That was 2-in-1. Now this is 3-in-1. Okay. So a large circle represents medially and finally light or heavy combinations of S and Z. Like S. Says, zest, zez, like that. The large circle medially and finally represents I will write light or heavy. That means sas, sas, zas, zaz, like that. Okay. With an intervening vowel of A. Light sound. A. Sharp one. A. Light dot. A. Second place, like that. Unit output. Only sound. A. That means in our system, without writing, we can catch the sound. That is the possibility is there. Without writing the sign, we will catch the sound. So, the large circle medially and finally, this is important, medially and finally, in a word, represents 2 S's, light or heavy, that means like this, with an intervening vowel of A, that means says, says, zes, zes, like that. Any song, you need that particularly here. Sun, that's all. Kazan. Here, the letter is S only, but the sound is Kazan. Finally, that's all. Kazan. Kazan. Spelling is different. Sound is different. Now, the spelling is C-A-U, S-E-S will give the sound of Kazan. Then, ah, then, sense. Fair sense. Aren't they?
Other than
A. Winter means two S's concern global sign is written inside the large circle. Large circle. The concerned global sign. The relevant. Concern means the relevant. Relevant global sign. If other than global comes, suppose insist in two S's that it is not A, E, insist. So, insist in sist, insist. This vowel is in. Okay, because the large circle has come, just like a moon, it moved like this. Insist. Insist. Okay. So, what is the concern? What is this vowel saying? E, other than A. It is a light dot. Isn't it? Light dot. This is, E is represented by a light dot. So, that light dot is present inside the large circle. Okay. Exhaust. Exhaust. See? Exhaust. 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 Okay. Exhaust. 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 Oh. How is represented by A? Exhaust. This is A. A. Exhaust. 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 This is a very big spelling. Oh. It's a all. All means. This is the combination. Exhaust. Z. S. Ah. Z. Ah. S. Exhaust. Therefore, now, it is written, the, what is the vowel sign represented by A? Heavy dash. Heavy dash. So, it is written, simply, that vowel sign is written inside the large circle. Exist. Here, gear sound is also there, isn't it? Exist. Egg. Here. Z, 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 e, s. Okay. Exist. Now, this e is represented by a light dot. So, the dot is placed inside the large circle. Exist. So, if other than a vowel intervenes between two S's, the concerned or the relevant vowel sign is written inside the large circle. So, if other than a vowel intervenes two S's, the relevant vowel sign is indicated by writing that vowel sign inside the large circle. Exercised. 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 I return. exercised. This I occurred between this and I. What is the sign for this I? It is a diphthong. Diphthong comes from vowel family only. So it is considered the vowel sign. Exercised. Okay. Exercised. Okay? Exercised. Exercise. Exercise. So, other than A occurs between two S's. This is one S. This is another S. Between that, between two S's, I diphthong sign. It is written, diphthong sign is written inside the large circle. Now, suppose X star phi Z, another S has come, then X star phi Z. You see, how X star phi Z. So, a small circle can also be added to the larger circle. A small circle can also be added to the large circle in a very rare cases like this. How will you write size? This is I. Can you write like this and put the diphthong sign? No, isn't it? Because there is no other consonant attached. So you cannot put. So large circle is used for two S's combination of other light and heavy sounds. Here in this case, is and is. Medially and finally only. Not like this when standing alone. But here, there is one rule. How you write size? You write? No. Size. You will write like this. Strokes and circles. There is one rule in the strokes chapter. You will have to write this stroke only. There is one rule. What is that rule? Initial S followed by a vowel and another S or Z. That rule is applicable. But you cannot put, you cannot write like this. Now, the large circle can also be used in some cases where two consecutive syllables come with the sounds of two S's. For example, you see, the large circle is also used to represent the two sounds of S in consecutive syllables. For example, miss spell. For example, here the first word ended with F. The second form started with F. So, how do you write miss spell? Isn't it? So, this circle, two circles join, not circle. Misspell. Like, misspell. You can write like this also. Misspell. Oh, this was also, yeah. You can put here, what is there? You can put here, somewhere. We are not putting lightly sounded vowel signs at all. And even heavy sounded vowels also we are omitting, we are not writing, except diphthongs and triphones. Okay? Okay. But there is a provision. So the large circle is also used in such cases. Very small number of cases. Another example I will give. This city, this city, isn't it? City. Here, this form ended with the small circle, this form started with the small circle. Therefore, this city, extensive use of large circle. So, it is an extensive use of a large circle. The logic here is, then we are going to unite two small circles, a large circle will be formed. Like this. Miss Spell. This circle and this circle forms into Miss Spell. I will give you another example. Lose sales. Lose sales. Combined. Lose sales. How do you write? Lose sales. Like this. Lose sales. Lose sales. Like this. Two small circles then consecutively occur. They can be united to form into a large circle. So we can write the word quickly. That is the aim. There is an extensive use of this large circle. See. A race. Where's the horse? How do you write race? Race. Horse. Isn't it? Race, horse. Then put together a race. Horse. Race. Horse. Like this. Now, it is not F and F, but it is H. Horse. H is having a small circle. Small circle. So, this is small circle, that is small circle. Made into a large circle. You will see this example in future, in one of the future chapters. Okay. But I am telling you how these circles are united. This is the extensive use of large circle. No, you are writing a very, very big circle. It should not be huge circle. Okay, it is a large circle. Circle, small circle, large circle. But don't write huge circle. This is very big. Okay. See, the use of a large circle is restricted sometimes, in very rare cases, in very rare cases. You see, in plurals and possessive cases, where in the root word strokes is written, in the plurals and possessive cases also, the strokes is retained. I will give you an example. Policy. How do you write? Policy. 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 Policies. Policies.
all things.
Here, this is the root word, this is the derivative, cognate form. So in the root word, you have written scrotus. So in the derivative also, especially in the plural, policies, it's a plural. So you retain the scrotus because it was written in the root word.
Retain the scrotus.
Legacy.
Legacy, you write. Legacy.
Legacy is. Just add. Just add a stroke as add success. Legacies. In plurals. In plurals, in the root word, stroke is written. Therefore, in the derivative of plural, add the subject and retain. Keep it. Keep that stroke as it was written in the root word. Now in the possessive cases, very rare. For example, Lucy. It's a proper name. Lucy. Lucy. Proper name. Suppose Lucy's possessive case. Lucy's book. So Lucy's. You retain this strokes. You retain the strokes because in the root word strokes is used. In the root word strokes is used. Therefore, you retain in the possessive case also. Lucy's. So like this, in plurals and possessive cases, the strokes which was used in the root word may be retained in these cases also. May be retained in these cases, plurals and possessive cases also. There are words for which outlines are similar. Suppose there are two words. The outlines for these words are similar. For example, you see, cases. How do you write cases? You can write cases. Ses. That means yes, yes. Two S's with an intervening vowel of A. A is the built-in, built-in sound. We need not write. Okay. Therefore, finally, a large circle represents S's. So we have written K-S's. Okay. X's. Suppose. X's. Excess also can be written like this. Now, suppose you don't put all sign. Then there will be a clash. While making out the outlines, while reading, it is difficult for us. Some inconvenience is there. We can make out according to the context of the sentence. But there is some inconvenience. There are certain words which have similar outlines. In such cases, we will have to distinguish one from the other. So there is a small rule. For the sake of distinction between
two words having similar outlines, the large circle is not used in one of them.
So there may be two words having similar outlines. As I said, suppose cases, cases we can use. Suppose excess, excess, is that it? Excess, cess. Yes, a between two s's. A need not be put. It is inbuilt, inbuilt sound. Okay. Now cases, excess. Generally, we don't put normal signs. In such cases, of course, we can make out the outline according to the context in the sentence. But to avoid inconvenience, we use large circle in one outline, large circle is restricted in the other. Now, excess is written like this, excess. So, in one outline, large circle is used. In the other, it is not used. So that one outline is distinguished from the other. So that there may not be any confusion or inconvenience. Another example. Races. 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 We have this. Races. What also can be? Here, races. Races. So, in order to distinguish races from races, races. So, here, last circle is not used. Here, the logic is, the word pronounced quickly, abbreviated form is used. So in words which are taken more time to pronounce, abbreviated form is not used. So that it can be distinguished from the other, because both are having similar outlines. Another reason is, the frequency of use of the word. The word which has got more frequency in usage, for that abbreviated form is used so that it can be written quickly. There are only a few words where distinctive forms are needed. So, this large circle will be used in the phrasigraphy also. Large circle is used in phrases as follows. As we, for as we can use, for as we, as we have, as we can, as well as, for example. So this last circle is used, this yes and the way, isn't it? Here as well as verb,
as
ever we
see, as we have, as we can, as well as,
like this,
as well as.
That yours?
As well as.
So, the of there is. So we can use.
In this city.
This is also phrase and also extensive use. You see?
In this city. You are using. Okay. So, this circle and this circle. This circle, this. In this city.
Okay. In this city, it is used. We generally do not vocalize the phrases.
Okay. In this city. So here is his
Reserve graphic.